those that say, you can test too much. You do know that.
Who says that?
Oh, just read the manuals, read the books.
Manuals?
Read the books.
What manuals?
Read the books.
What books?
What testing does... Let me explain. What testing does, it shows cases. It shows where there may be cases.
I've covered you for a long time. I've gone to your rallies. I've talked to your people. They love you. They listen to you. They listen to every word you say. They hang on your every word. They don't listen to me or the media or Fauci. They think we're fake news. They want to get their advice from you. And so when they hear you say everything's under control, don't worry about wearing masks, I mean, these are people, many of them are older people,
what's
Mr. President.
What's your definition of control? Yeah, under the
it's giving them a false sense
right
of security.
Now, I think it's under control. I'll tell you what.
How? 1,000 Americans are dying a day.
They are dying. That's true. And you it is what it is. But that doesn't mean we aren't doing everything we can. When I took over, we didn't even have a test. Now, in all fairness,
why would you have a test?
There was no test.
The virus didn't
exist.
How would you have a test?
I was going to say.
Okay. Death is going up now. Okay. And it's 1,000 a day.
If you look at death.
Yeah, it's going up again.
Let's look.
Daily death.
Take a look at some of these charts.
I'd love to.
We're going to look.
Let's look.
And if you look at death.
Yeah. Started to go up again.
Well, right here, the United States is lowest. In numerous categories, we're lower than the world.
Lower than the world?
Lower than Europe.
In what? In what?
Take a look. Right here. Here's case death.
Oh, you're doing death as a proportion of cases. I'm talking about death as a proportion of population. That's where the U.S. is really bad.
Well,
much worse than South Korea, Germany, et cetera.
You can't do that. You have to go by... You have to go by where, look, here is the United States. You have to go by the cases.
Why not as a proportion of population?
When you have somebody, what it says is when you have somebody that has, where there's a case.
Oh, okay.
The people that live from those cases.
It's surely a relevant statistic to say if the U.S. has X population and X percentage of death of that population versus South Korea.
No, you have to go by the cases.
Well, look at South Korea, for example. 51 million population, 300 deaths. It's crazy compared to...
You don't know that.
I do. It's
you
on the,
don't know
it's,
that. Don't,
you think they're faking their statistics? South Korea?
An advanced country? I won't get into that because I have a very good relationship with the country. But you don't know that.
1,000 Americans are dying a day. But I understand on cases, it's different.
No, but you're not reporting it correctly, Jonathan.
I think I am, but... It's been widely reported that the U.S. has intelligence indicating that Russia paid bounties... or offered to pay bounties to Taliban fighters to kill American soldiers. Mm-hmm. You had a phone call with Vladimir Putin on July 23rd. Did you bring up this issue?
No, that was a phone call to discuss other things.
And you've never discussed it with him?
I have never discussed it with him, no. I would, I'd have no problem with it.
But you don't believe the intelligence? It's because you don't believe the intelligence, that's why.
It never reached my desk. You know why? Because they didn't think it was intelligence. They didn't think it was real.
It was in your written brief, though, apparently.
They didn't think it was worthy of... I wouldn't mind. If it reached my desk, I would have done something about it. It never reached my desk because...
Do you read your written brief?
I do.
Do you?
I read a lot.
Really?
You know, I read a lot. They like to say I don't read. I read a lot.
Your daily intelligence brief?
I comprehend extraordinarily well, probably better than anybody that you've interviewed in a long time. I did more for the black community than anybody, with the possible exception of Abraham Lincoln, whether you like it or not. People say, oh, that's
you really, you believe you did more than Lyndon Johnson, who passed the Civil Rights Act?
I think I did, yeah.
How?
Because I
How
got
possibly
criminal justice
did you do...
reform done. I got prison reform.
Lyndon Johnson. He passed the Civil Rights Act.
How has it worked out? If you take a look at what Lyndon Johnson did.
You think the Civil Rights Act was a mistake?
How has it worked out? Because frankly, it took a long time. But for African Americans, under my administration, Jonathan, under my administration, African Americans were doing better than they had ever done in the history of this country.
How do you think history will remember John Lewis?
I don't know. I really don't know. I don't know. I don't know John Lewis. He chose not to come to my inauguration. He chose. I never met John Lewis, actually. I don't believe.
Do you find him impressive?
I was working from home. I wasn't going out anywhere. I was taking precautions. I wasn't even walking my dog. This is not a hoax. This virus is real. It happened to me. It can happen to them. I went to the emergency room. Everything happened so quickly. They took my vitals. My oxygen pool was very low. Within 10 minutes, I only had a couple of minutes to contact my family to let them know that I was to be intubated. All I remember was being put to sleep as I was being intubated, and then 6 weeks of complete nightmares. They were explaining the option of lung transplantation because my lungs were, you know, irreversibly damaged, and it was a last option for me. There wasn't anything else that they could do. My other organs were starting to fail as well. 48 hours later, I received my lung transplant on June 5th. I had no idea that I had received a lung transplant. I just know I was in the hospital. I looked at myself. I couldn't recognize my own body. I couldn't talk. I could barely lift a finger. I couldn't move. I was in a lot of pain. I was very confused. I was very thirsty. All I could think about was that I wanted water. I lost a lot of cognitive abilities as well as physical abilities. I'm still in a lot of pain. I'm very weak. I'm working on my endurance and strength. I'm still struggling to breathe and learning how to use my new lungs. I know some people are asymptomatic. They should still be careful and be considerate of those more vulnerable around them. Also, I want other centers to understand that lung transplantation is an option for terminally ill COVID patients, and I want to be an example of that.
How do you even begin to plan a life or a future in a country that thinks that people's lives are disposable? Entire neighborhoods have been completely decimated. The Beirut governor said today that 300,000 people in Beirut were now homeless due to damages to their homes. We found that the hospital sector really was in crisis due to the financial crisis in the country. And the reasons were that first, the government was failing to pay the dues that it owes hospitals. So at that time, it owed private hospitals an estimated $1.3 billion in accrued bills since 2011. This was obviously impacting the ability of hospitals to pay for their staff, to pay for doctors, nurses, medicines, medical equipment. You had the economic crisis, which was caused by the dollar shortage in the country. And as the dollars increasingly became scarce in Lebanon, the value of the Lebanese pound depreciated rapidly. This placed a huge burden on importers who were struggling to come up with the dollars necessary to be able to purchase medical supplies and equipment. And Lebanon imports almost all of the medical supplies and equipment that it uses. And, you know, due to this dollar shortage, medical importers told us that they were running out of vital equipment like blood bags, kidney dialysis filters, heart stents, catheters. And they were warning that we might start seeing people going to hospital and dying because doctors just didn't have the right equipment to deal with the emerging medical needs. So just a day before this blast, hospital officials were warning that they were reaching capacity and that they will not have space anymore to accept new coronavirus patients. They were running out of personal protective equipment like masks, gloves, gowns. They were running out of ventilators and could not replace spare parts and ventilators that were faulty. Two hospitals were, completely destroyed by the blast. I was at one of those hospitals and saw medical teams evacuating patients, doctors, and nurses from a building that had completely collapsed. There was no electricity in the building anymore, so nurses and doctors were having to take out patients to the parking lot and treat people in the parking lot using their mobile phones for light. People had to be taken as far away for treatment as Nabatieh in the south and Tripoli in the north, which are about 70 to 80 kilometers away from Beirut. I can speak for my family who grew up here in Lebanon during the civil war, and they have said that even during the height of the war, the situation was not this bad. And they had not seen this level of just corruption and negligence from the ruling class that they are seeing today. Several embassies have said that they've received an unprecedented amount of applications from Lebanon for immigration. And people saying that they've completely lost hope in Lebanon, people saying that they want to leave this country, that they've given so much, but that has taken away everything from them. Unfortunately, you know, Lebanon's track record is not impressive. We routinely see the Lebanese government and authorities announce investigations after instances of government abuse or neglect. Unfortunately, we never find out the results of these investigations, and we never find out what accountability proceedings, if any, have been undertaken against those responsible for the abuse.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. My coronavirus hits me so hard. All the teachers say, oh my lord, COVID is stressing me. All the updates from the CDC, Lysol can't be found. I've looked all around this town. I've had no luck. And these are the things, huh, you can't touch. I told you, students,
you can't touch this.
You better pull that mask up.
You can't touch this.
It's the CDC, not me.
You can't touch this.
Hey, go wash your hands.
You can't can't touch this.
Fresh new rules and plans, let's all be safe. Go wash your hands, so move back up 6 feet. You better not cough and you better not sneeze. Sanitation. Hold on, let me check your temp. Not under your arm, like that. Like that, you're all clear, go to the back. Everybody says that this is too much, and these are the things that you can't touch. Yo, I told you.
You can't touch this.
Why are y'all standing so close? Back up.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this.
Every time you see me, Dr. Lee is sanitized. I'm gonna keep my hand clean, cause the cases are on the rise. Now why would I ever stop doing this? While others getting ill, I don't wanna be sick. I've been to all the classroom from upstairs into the gym. It's Lee, go Lee, Dr. Lee, yo doc, you're late. Look at the clock, can't touch this. Can't touch this. Break it down. Six feet. Stop. Sanitize. While others getting ill, I don't wanna be sick. I've been to all the classroom from upstairs into the gym. It's Lee, go Lee, Dr. Lee, yo doc, you're late. Look at the clock, can't touch this. Can't touch this. Break it down. 6 feet. Sanitize.
Bottom line is, it's like the flu. This is a mild flu.
No, but there are a lot more cases, Frank. There are a lot more cases, and people are getting more sick, and different people are getting sick than get sick with the flu.
You're knocking Trump because of the total numbers.
I'm not knocking Trump because he's not doing. Hold on.
53.3% of the deaths, 0.6% of the population.
Frank.
Bottom line, that's a stat that nobody's talking about.
Frank, watch your mouth. We're on television.
They actually say that liquor stores are essential. Every place that you can go into Home Depot and Lowe's is essential. I disagree with that. Okay, we're all essential. Everybody's essential. And bottom line is, this isn't about opening up a gym. They have violated everyone's constitutional rights. We all have the right to make a living. We all have a right to actually do what we want to do as Americans. We are promised liberty. And they have actually put such oppressive restrictions on us that it's just unacceptable to us.
We're being blamed by the governor for being reckless when we're doing more than what he does in long-term care facilities.
I get your argument. I get your argument, and I think that you should have a fair hearing.
It's out of control. It's out of control. It's all that happens is conclusionary statements with no science and data to back up that our gym or any small business for that matter is more responsible for deaths and the spread of COVID than any other one.
I don't think all I'll say is, I don't think death is the right metric.
I would argue that the gym is a place to keep people safe. You know, this is a place where people come to build their immune systems, to build the strength of their body physically on the outside and the inside. We're being villainized as small businesses in general that we're responsible for this spread, but over 50% of the deaths are coming from places that are supposed to be under governor's control.
I understand, and there's no question, Frank. Frank, give me a chance. Give me a chance, Frank.
16. We have had 15,009 visits to our facility, zero positive cases.
When you come into our gym, you actually stand in front of a biometric scanner that takes your temperature. You take a disinfected pen, you fill out a health questionnaire, just like you would at a doctor's office. You take that pen and you put it in a dirty bin so we can actually disinfect it. You're handed a bottle of a disinfectant that is actually from Ecolab that actually is proven to actually kill the coronavirus in 45 seconds. What is the right metric? Oh, healthy people,
Frank,
are not dying.
Frank. Deaths.
Healthy
well, that's
people
not true.
Are not dying.
That's not true.
I lost my mother from this.
I'm very sorry.
You're barking up the wrong tree.
I'm not barking up any tree.
My mother got it in the hospital.
Frank.
My mother got it in the hospital where they're supposed to protect.
I am very sorry about that. And I'm sorry she got it. I'm sorry she succumbed to it. But I'm not attacking you for it. I'm saying that death isn't the only way to measure the risk.